Hello everyone and welcome back to this channel. Today we will create this game. The name of the game is 2Car and it was released by Kechapp. Now let's start the game. The game is simple but it is really hard to play. If the car touches the circle, you will get a point, and if the car touches the square, the game is over. And if the circle hit the edge of the screen, then also the game is over. So now let's start creating this game. First of all, open Unity and create a new project. I have created a new project and the Unity version which I am using is 2018.3. Now let's create a folder for the assets. I have created few assets for this game. These are the assets which I have created. Now let's drag and drop this in our project and change the sprite mode to sprite 2D. I have already done this in my project. Hit on apply. Now let's create an empty 2D sprite game object for the background. Background is quite big according to the camera. Now let's change the camera size. I will change it to 9. Great. Now we can see the whole sprite. Now let's create an empty game object for the player. I will name it player and inside it I will create a 2D sprite game object. I will drag and drop the car sprite inside this and I will again rename it to blue car, increase the size a little bit and change the position of the car. Now let's duplicate it and I will rename it to orange car, drag and drop the orange sprite. Now let's create a script for this car. I will create a new folder and I will rename it to script. Now let's create a new script and I will name it car. Open the script in editor. Now let's create few variables. I have created a first lane blue car variable and first lane orange car variable which is a bool type, and we will set it to true when we want to move the car game object. Now let's create a new bool variable and I will name it blue car, and for the blue car game object I will set it to true. Let's create a new vector2 variable and I will name it x position. This will store the X position where the car have to move when we click. Now inside the update, if we press the left arrow or the right arrow, we will call the left button press method or the right button press method. And inside the left button press method, I have changed the first lane car blue variable to true if it is false, else I will change it to true. And do the same thing for the right button press method. Now inside the update, if blue car is true and inside these bracket, if first lane blue car is true, then we will change the transform of the game object position to a new vector 3 position. I have written minus x position dot y because we want the game object to move in the left half of the plane, and the y position will be same, and the game object will move from transform dot position to a new vector 3 position in 0.1 second. Else we will move the game object position to the minus x value of the x position variable. Now write the same statement inside the else bracket. Here, if the first lane orange car bool variable is true, we will move the game object position to the y value of the x position variable. Now let's drag and drop this. Now to write the x position value, we will create an empty game object. Now I want to move the game object between 4 and 1.12. Write the same value in the orange car game object, and for the blue car I will take the blue car variable to true. Now let's test the application. Great. If we press the left arrow, the left car is moving, and if we press the right arrow, the right car is moving. Now let's create some square and circular game object. I will create an empty game object and I will rename it to circle blue, and inside that I will create a new 2D sprite game object. I will drag and drop the blue circle sprite inside this and I will duplicate it to create a square blue game object. I will drag and drop the square sprite inside this and I will again duplicate it to create a circle blue game object. I will drag and drop the circle sprite inside this, now duplicate it to create a square orange game object. I will drag and drop the square sprite inside this. Now we have to create a script for these game object. I will name it circle square game object. Drag and drop this script inside this game object and add the box and circle collider to this game object and change it to trigger. Now open the script in editor Now inside the script, we will create a speed variable which will control the speed of this game object, and we will create a rigid body 2D variable. And in the start, we will take a rigid body 2D component by using get component and set the rigid body velocity so that it will move in the minus y direction. And I will provide 10 to the speed value. Now let's add rigid body to all these game object, and I will change it to kinematic, and I will change the collision detection to discrete. Now let's create tag for these game object. I will click on tag and then add tag. I will create two tag, one is cube and other is circle, and assign the cube tag to the cube game object and assign the circle tag to the circle game object. Now let's test if the script is working correctly. The game object are moving in the correct direction. Now let's create a game controller script and which will instantiate these game object. I will create a new script and I will name it game controller. And inside the script, first I will write two variable which will take the blue and orange game object. And I will create two variable which is a float type, start weight variable which take the value, after which we will instantiate the game object. And how much time we will wait between instantiating game object is depend on spawn wait time. Blue and orange game object will store the game object which we will instantiate. The x position variable will store the x position where we will instantiate the game object. Now let's create a coroutine to instantiate these game object, and I will name it spawn objects. Inside this coroutine, first we will wait till the start wait time, and after the start wait time we will instantiate the game object, and while it is true we will start the for loop which will run from 0 to 50. We will instantiate 50 game object. First we will choose the x position on which lane we have to instantiate the game object. Then I will provide that x position to the orange x position variable which is of vector 3 type. Now we have to choose between square and circle which game object we have to instantiate. Now instantiate the game object at the orange position, and after this we will wait till the spawn wait time and repeat the same step for the blue game object. We will instantiate this in the minus x position so that it will go in the left half. After this we will wait till the spawn time and again run the loop and again instantiate the game object. Now inside the start, let's start this coroutine. Head over to Unity and let's test the application. I will drag and drop this game controller script. I will change the size to 2 and I will drag and drop the blue game object. I will change the start weight to true and I will change the spawn weight to 1. Now let's start the application. Now I will create a new game object and I will name it Edge Collider. I will move it down and add a box collider to it. I will change the scale of the box collider. I will create a script for this edge collider game object and I will name it edge collider. So inside the script, we have to write the functionality that if the game object which is collided with this game object has a tag name cube, we will destroy the game object. And if the game object has the tag circle, then the game is over. We will call the game over method of the game controller class which we have to create. For the game over method, let's create a game over bool variable, and in the start game over variable will be false. Let's rename it to game over bool, and when this game over method is called, we will change the game over bool to true. And let's create a start game method, and when this method is called, we will start spawning the object. Inside the game over, change the time scale to 0. When the time.timescale is 0, means game will stop, game will not run. And inside the start, change the time scale to 1. We will call this method from the start canvas. Now let's create an empty canvas and I will name it start game canvas. I will change the scale mode to scale with screen size and change the resolution to 480 into 800. Now let's create a button inside this canvas. Let's create a panel and change the color to black. Move it above the button so that we can click on the button. And when this button is pressed, we will call the start game method of the game controller script and hide the canvas. Now let's test the application. Great, everything is working till now. Now let's add the functionality. If the game object having the tag circle is collide with the player, we will give point to the player. And if the game object of the tag cube is collided with the player, we will call the game over method of the game controller class. Let's create an empty canvas. I will name it game canvas. Change the resolution to 480 into 800. Now let's create a functionality that if the user click on the left half, the blue car will move, and if the user click on right half, the right car will move. I will change the size of the button so that it will cover the left half of the screen. Duplicate it and change it to right half button. I will change the alpha value of the button to 0. Now when the left half button is clicked, we will call the left button press method of the blue car game object. And when the right half button is pressed, we will call the right button press method of the orange car game object. Now let's test the application. This is really good. This script is working fine. Now let's create a score canvas as well. If the car hit the circle, we will give score to the player and update the score canvas. And create a text element under the score canvas. I will change the scale of the text and change the font size as well. Now let's add the outline so that it will be more visible. Now inside the game controller script, let's create few variables. We will create a score variable which will store the score of the player. We will take the reference of the text game object, not text alignment, text game object. To use text in our script, we have to import unity.ui in our script. Now let's create a method. I will name it addScore. And when this method is called, we will simply increase the score and give the value to the score text. And this method is called when the player hit the game object who has a circle tag. Let's create a game over canvas variable as well, which will show or hide the game over canvas. So in the start, we will change the game over canvas to false. So in the start, we will hide the game over canvas, and when the game is over, we will show the game over canvas. Now let's create a method to restart the scene. To restart the scene, we will create a restart method. Inside this method, we will just restart the scene. Head over to Unity and let's create an empty canvas. I will change the screen resolution and scale mode. I will create an empty text. I will change the size of the text. And this will be game over text. And write game over. I will create a button as well. I will hide the image. I will change the text to restart. I will create a panel and move it above the text. And when this button is called, we will call the restart method of the game controller class. Now drag and drop the game over canvas to the field and the text to the score text field. Now let's start the application. Great, all the script are working correctly. I have made this game easy so that I can score, but in real game I can't score much. Congratulations, you have again created a game. And if you have learned anything from this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel. And thank you so much for sharing your support. See you in the next video. The end. Ta-da.